I went to South Korea this January. At that time, the COVID-19 was started in Korea. I thought COVID-19 was an influenza. However, March 9th, WHO declared COVID-19 is a global pandemic. Hello, my name is Grace Kang. Today, I want to talk about COVID-19. Oh. COVID-19 is started from the Wuhan, China since December 2019. It spread from Asia to the Europe, to the United States, and eventually all around the world. According to the Johns Hopkins data, on April 22nd, there are more than 800,000 people confirmed the case and more than 45,000 people died from COVID-19. We are in pandemic situation because it is easy to transmit and there is no vaccine or treatment. So today, I want to talk about why it is important to protect ourselves from this virus. First, I want to define what is COVID-19 and how to transfer to human to human. Second, I want to talk about the symptoms and diagnosis. And third, I will give you an information about the treatment and prevention method. There are words for coronavirus and COVID-19. So first, I want to make sure what is COVID-19. COVID-19 is one of the large family of the virus, which name is coronavirus. So there are different types of coronavirus. Well known are MERS and SARS. So COVID-19 is stand for CO for the corona, VI for the virus, D for the disease, and number 19 for 2019. So basically it means 2019 novel coronavirus. It transmits to human to human. The reservoir is a bat. It's primarily spreading through the respiratory tract by droplet and direct contact. It is very high transmissible because it can be asymptomatic even they have a virus. So we do not know who has a virus or not. The symptoms are very common. It is a cold or flu-like symptoms. The main symptoms are fever, cough, fatigue, septum production, shortness of breath, sore throat, and dry cough and headache. Gastrointestinal symptoms such as diarrhea and vomiting also considered as a symptoms of COVID-19. It starts with mild and begin gradually. According to a military medical research on March 13th, the Chinese scientists who studied the COVID-19 patient, they said the elder with a certain disease, such as hypertension, diabetes, and cardiovascular disease, they developed the symptoms rapidly and even leading to the death. The symptoms of COVID-19 typically appear within 14 days after initial exposure to the virus. If you have a symptoms or suspect to exposure to the virus, you can go to the hospital and test for it. The basic diagnosis testing is the PCR testing. The PCR testing is collect the sample from your nose or throat and testing if there are COVID-19 genomes or not. The chest X-ray and chest CT can be used for the testing the pulmonary fibrosis because the pulmonary fibrosis is the main damage from the COVID-19. The diagnosis is pretty simple, but it is important to test in an isolated places because we do not know yet the subject is positive or negative. There are no treatment or vaccines. However, according to an infectious disease report on March 17th, the Italian physician reported that the mainly focus on the symptomatic and respiratory support, such as medication for fever, pain reliever, or antimicrobial therapy. Oral rehydration and oxygen therapy can be used for the supportive care. So if you have a mild symptom, such as cough or sore throat, stay home and take a rest, drink a lot of water, and use the humidifier to ease your symptom. So basically, the mild symptoms is focused on the to ease your symptoms. But if you have severe symptoms such as the high fever or difficult to breathe, then I recommend to go to the hospital immediately. Due to there are no treatment or vaccine, it is important to boost up your immune systems. And the prevention is the only method to avoid the COVID-19 right now. The prevention methods are wash your hands for the 30 seconds with the soaps, and alcohol sanitizer might help to kill the virus. Cover your nose and mouth when you sneeze or cough, and cover your face when you go outside. Taking a vitamin C can help to boost up your immune systems. However, the best thing to protect yourself from this virus is to avoid the crowded places, to stay at home as much as you can, and to stay a distance from others. Today, I talk about the why we need to protect ourselves from the COVID-19. First, I define the COVID-19 and how to transfer this virus to human to human. Second, I talk about the symptoms and diagnosis. And third, I gave you an information of the treatment and prevention method. Everything is stopped because of the COVID-19. The factory, cars, even schools are closed right now. However, COVID-19 has been contributed for restoring our environmental pollution. Especially air and water, water quality has been significantly improved these days of the COVID-19 pandemic. I heard that the dolphins and swans are came back to Venice Canal, and the CNN field producer Rebecca Wright reported that she reported on the April 1st that air pollution in New Delhi has been remarkably decreased after social distancing in India. COVID-19 reminded us that we are the part of the nature and how humans destroy it. Maybe it is time to quarantine for our safe and think about the meaning of our life. Thank you for listening to my presentation, and I hope you guys enjoy it.
Yeah.
Thank you.